the age of 21, he received an insurance payout of $110,500. And he used the money to catch a boat to England, maybe Spain. He did well on the folk scene here, which was vibrant in 1965. Paul Simon, Small Paul, produced his eponymously titled first album. It is said that Jackson was so shy that he performed from behind a screen. Bert Jans played Jackson songs throughout his career. They're also covered by Nick Drake, Sandy Denny, Simon and Garfunkel, and countless others to this day. Jackson's mental health began to deteriorate and he suffered writer's block. Running out of money, he returned to New York and fell apart before the eyes of those who loved and admired him. The songs he struggled to write became dissonant, thrashing, impenetrable. By 1970, he was begging friends for help. They tried, even repackaged his first album, but it garnered little interest. During a brief period of stability in here somewhere, he married an English woman, and they made a son and a daughter. Their son died from cystic fibrosis, and Jackson plummeted into a pit of depression which saw him institutionalized on more than one occasion. Jackson C. Frank was diagnosed as a paranoid schizophrenic. Desperate in 1985, he took a trip to New York to try to locate the now famous Paul Simon. His mother found him gone, having left no forwarding address on her return from hospital where she'd undergone heart surgery. Jackson wound up living on the street. Jim Abbott, a fan, found him in 1990 and tried to help. Jackson was now a beast and very unkempt. A further side effect of the school fire was thyroid malfunction, causing massive weight gain. Jackson tried to play a cheap guitar for Jim, wouldn't stay in tune. He even made a few demo recordings at around this time, but no one was much interested, so he tried some new stuff at open mic gigs. Shortly after this, Jackson was sitting on a bench, minding his own business. Some kids across the way were messing around with a pellet gun. The gun went off, and a pellet met catastrophically with Jackson's left eye. Jackson C. Frank died of pneumonia and cardiac arrest on March the 3rd, 1999. He was 56 years old. At the time of writing this, I am 56 years old. I've just learned to play Jackson's most famous song on my guitar. For years after hearing it at a folk club when I was a kid, I thought it was called Catch a Boat to England. I've known for a while now, of course, that the actual title is Blues Run the Game.
Wherever I have gone, wherever I have gone.